If you spent hundreds of hours on this plan, how did you not know that this consultant had used his ideas in multiple places? And included in your plan, there are word-for-word copies of four other governors' plans.
Well, I read through every single one of these ideas, but I didn't necessarily read through all the plans of other governors. And so Mr. Schnur was one of the people that we utilized to put together this plan. And he, these are some ideas and best practices that he saw going on around the rest of the country and that he had brought to here, to us. But I wouldn't have included them if I didn't think that they were good for Wisconsin. And any ones that are not his language and what he used in other plans are cited from other sources. We have something like 83 footnotes in this plan, so there is a lot of sourcing of where this information came from.
There's been some questioning because of this issue with the consultant and whatnot, that this can somehow undermine your authenticity or your credibility in your campaign, and even connections made to the fact that you are on the Madison School Board, and students wouldn't necessarily be able to do what was done in this plan. Do you believe this undermines your credibility as a candidate?
Absolutely not. As I said, every single passage, and I'll tell you, it's a very small part of the 44 pages and ideas that are in here that are being cited, but every single one of those, if it's not Mr. Schnur's own language that he has used, it is cited and it's footnoted. And so that's the standard that we do hold people to. And I'm very proud of the plan, and as I have been very clear from the start of this, is that these really are best practices and good ideas that I think will work in Wisconsin and that I have taken from other places. As an executive with Turk Bicycle, we always looked at how we could improve the company by looking around us, not only in our own industry, but in other industries to say, hey, what are successful companies doing? What are their best practices? How do they, you know, what do they use in terms of organizing their company around product design? That's how good organizations move forward. Not every idea has to be an original idea. It has to be ideas that are going to work, that are based on best practices. That's what really good public policy is about. And so I definitely stand by my plan. I'm very proud of these ideas and of the ones that are going to make sure that we are growing.
So what in this plan is a unique Mary Burke idea? Or is this plan primarily an aggregation of all these other ideas from other places that you think are good?
Well, I would say a lot of these plans, I'm trying to think, Jessica, whether, okay, was I the first person who ever thought of this idea? Well, you know, I don't know about that, but I can tell you one thing that's in this plan that I said, I want to make sure that we have in this plan is the possible use and growth of anaerobic digesters. You know, I think that it has possibilities because it addresses an environmental problem or helps to address an environmental problem. It can make our farms more competitive. It also actually takes advantage of the strong research and manufacturing capabilities that we have here in Wisconsin. And if we were a leader in this area, I think we could benefit in three or four different areas because of that. So I'm not saying I was the first one to ever think of digesters, but it's in this plan because I thought that it would be a great idea for Wisconsin.
If you had to point to one thing in your plan that would make the biggest jobs impact, I think that's what a lot of people are making their decision on. Who can make this biggest impact on jobs figures in the state? What is that one thing?
I'm going to have to disagree, Jessica, that there is one thing. Anyone who can boil it down to one thing, frankly, is probably a politician with a good soundbite. I am about plans that are going to work and implementing those plans in a way. Because you can also have plans, but if you don't implement it right, they're not going to be successful. I know that from my career at Trek, the leading the Boys and Girls Club. Those are things that you have to do in order to be successful. And so it really is. It's five core strategies that I've laid out in my jobs plan. People can go to burkeforwisconsin.com, read it, look at it, judge for yourself. I wish it was just one thing. If it was that easy, everyone would be doing it. It is tough work, and we shouldn't underestimate just what it is going to take. And that's why we have to put the politics aside. We have to focus on what's going to work.
The governor, though, has, I mean, it's pretty cut and dry. I mean, he says three things: cut property and income taxes, freeze technical college and UW tuition further and put new limits on welfare recipients and require them to do job training and drug testing. I mean, those are pretty easy for voters to digest takeaways. How would you contrast yourself? What's your position on income and property taxes? Would you cut them? Would you increase them? Where do you stand on those issues?
Governor Walker's proposals here, to me, they do sound like a career politician's. Because I'm a business person, those things aren't going to make sure that Wisconsin is a top 10 thriving economy. You need a lot more than that.